is the MIG, the Atomic Color. It's a weed pen grown in Iran and treated specifically for calligraphy in a process that takes over a year. I get these in Turkey and in Iraq. They're a little bit softer than bamboo. You have to recut them more often. That is not like bamboo does everything I need it to do. Then, what else? Okay. Then a more recent addition to the calligrapher's repertoire is this guy. It's called a Java reed. It's actually a type of thorngrass from Indonesia. It's incredibly hard. That's its benefit. You can cut this pen once and then write with it for months without having to recut it. It's said that actually one Ottoman painter was able to write the entire Quran from beginning to end with only cutting this Java reed once. Normally, if he was using one of these, like a Tanish Kalem, it would be every couple of pages he would have to recut it. Now, what I like to do is cut a pen, just so you can see how it goes down. I'll show you, get some like pretty fancy pen cutting tools. Ivory handles and stuff, which you can use. But I mean, this like design is still sold in Istanbul. It's just like a stick with a very short, sharp, hard blade. I like the utility knife, works pretty fine. I put a new blade in it because it gets real quick. So what you're gonna do, this piece of bamboo, you're gonna start a couple inches back to the top, and then like a long, wide, sweeping cut down the bottom. So that, you can see it's still pretty thick at the end, so what I'm gonna do is just gradually work down. And when it's pretty close to the bottom, what I'm gonna do is flip it over and put what we call a thumbnail on the back. And what that does is, at that point, it was like a half circle. So this part is flat, but this part is still round. What I want is flat is a blade. There's no round whatsoever. So I'm just gonna take it down a little bit at a time. There we go. That's it. Now, you can see it's still got a 90 degree angle on it. What I'm gonna do is I use this piece of bone. It's called a maqta from the Arabic qata to cut, so the place of cutting. Got this in Istanbul as well. I mean, you can use anything for this. You just want to like elevate it from the table a little bit and give it something hard to write on. Then I'm gonna pull the pen in a little bit, or the knife in a little bit, and when I cut it, I'm gonna glue down it. So what I want to do, this cut is the most important cut of the pen. It needs to be a single motion all the way through. I can't saw it, I can't work it in a couple of different cuts. It needs to be a single cut that goes all the way through, because otherwise you'll get splinters and shards and it won't cut right. It won't write correctly. There you go. You want to listen for it to make sure it's a single tone. Cut right through. So it's cut at the right angle. Then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take down the wings a little bit at a time. That should be ready to go, but what I'm going to do, lastly, I have a piece of emery cloth at 600 grit sandpaper. I just like to give a couple of just whacks with the sandpaper just to kind of get any splinters that I can't see now. And then, obviously, what I do, I have to test the pen if it works. So, I don't know if you can see in the inkwell, but what we do is we put a little raw silk fibers in the inkwell, and that serves two purposes. First of all, if I by accident knock the inkwell over, it doesn't spill. Second of all, allows you to regulate the amount of ink on any of your pen. Basically, as you go on, the pen gets stronger and stronger. The first cut of the pen is not going to be so premium. But as it goes on, it's kind of like a better. Now, in terms of paper, what we use
is, I mean, traditionally, there would be special paper smiths. But we can use a commercially available glossy paper, but traditionally speaking, white paper, pure white paper, Arabic calligraphy isn't really written on pure paper, on white paper, so what we do is we dye that same paper to like a cream color. We also mix our own ink. Traditionally, this is not the ink that I mix, this is a commercial ink, but the traditional ink of Arabic calligraphy is lamp black. It gets its name from the way in which the pigment is procured. It comes from kerosene lamps. When the lamp burns out, there's a layer of soot in the kerosene well, and you scrape that out, and then you mix it with gum arabic dissolved in distilled water, and then you just grind it, and grind it, and grind it in a mortar and pestle until you have a completely smooth ink. That would be and then you add more and more water till it's less and less of a tar consistency.